Now we start with the sacrum. Sacrum also, we drew this diagram of sacrum, sacral body, and here we draw lateral mass. This is the lateral mass of sacrum. This will be the lateral mass of the sacrum, which is also called ala of sacrum. This is called ala of sacrum. Posteriorly, we show this as vertebral canal, and posteriorly from here we show that there will be the lamina of the sacrum, which will proceed posteriorly, cross section of the sacrum. These two are the lateral masses, or they are called ala of sacrum, we know that. Now we divide the ala in two segments. See that it is not exactly midline. Anterior 2/3, posterior 1/3. Once again we divide in anterior 2/3. This will be 2/3, anterior 2/3, and this will be 1/3, posterior 1/3. And then here, very simple, if I give orange color to anterior 2/3, if I just fill this orange color in anterior 2/3, that means this anterior 2/3 of the lateral mass of the sacrum is developed from which element? From the costal element. So therefore, here I complete with orange color. Anterior 2/3 is developed from, let me write here, costal element, and posterior 1/3, if I complete, give it a blue color, this posterior 1/3 of the lateral mass or ala of the sacrum will be developed from transverse element. So here, this is how I give some color. And therefore, once again, we write down here, this will be transverse element. Again, it is asked in MCQs, Viva. Lateral mass or the ala of the sacrum, anterior 2/3, will develop from costal element. Posterior 1/3 will develop from transverse element. And now we enter the last segment. Remember, these are the development of the ribs. All these structures are nothing but we take it under development of the ribs. So therefore, now we go to the last segment in which we show the thoracic vertebrae. In the thoracic vertebrae, we also have to show the ribs. So thoracic vertebrae, we show here, and the body is, we know, what is the shape of the body? Heart shaped. The body will be heart shaped, and this is thoracic. Then here we show the vertebral canal, and then we show transverse process. Here also we show transverse process, and spinous process. This is what we show. Now we show the ribs. So therefore, this is how we draw the rib. costo vertebral joint and costo transverse joint. Costo vertebral, costo transverse. So therefore, if I color this so that this colored segment will be the ribs, and this is how each rib will develop. And now just 2 points we have to write here, and those 2 points will be that ribs are developed from costal elements. The ribs are developed from costal elements. Transverse processes of thoracic vertebrae will be developed from transverse element. Here in thoracic vertebral column, please note down, ribs will develop from costal element and transverse processes of thoracic vertebrae will develop from transverse element. These are asked in MCQ. So after this segment now, there will be anterior extension of these costal elements of the ribs. As anteriorly they extend from both the side, right and left side, they will pass in the intercostal muscles, and they are now known as costal arches, right and left side costal arches. What will happen to those costal arches? Those costal arches will join and form sternum. That is our next topic. Now here, we end our development of the ribs by noting down that each rib will ossify from three centers. The first ossification center will be for the head of the rib. Second and third ossification centers will be for the two tubercles present on the ribs. And these centers of ossification will start at puberty. Then what happens? The center of ossification for head of the rib will migrate above, just above that sclerotomic segment, where it will encroach upon the above sclerotomic segment, upper sclerotomic segment. Because of that migration of ossification center of the head of the rib, each rib is attached to consecutive two vertebrae. Lower facet of the rib is attached to the lower numerically corresponding vertebrae, and upper facet will be attached to the above vertebrae. This is the reason. Here we end our development of the ribs.